Hey there, my name's Drew Brashler, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to use snippets and custom controls inside of your Behringer wing for bypassing Waves SuperRack Performer on your wing. Now, in a previous video, I was showing you how to actually utilize the effects inserts to allow you to insert or uninsert an effects rack with Waves SuperRack Performer routed on the USB output of your Behringer wing. So if you haven't checked that out, go ahead and check that out because the link is down in the description below. But if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident with your production gear no matter where you're starting from. So let's go ahead and dive in. Now, I have my Waves SuperRack Performer on my computer here, and I have this microphone. Check one, two. So if I go and mute this inside of Waves SuperRack Performer, we will notice that I have audio, but it's not actually making it to the left. Right, and that's because I've muted it inside of Waves SuperRack Performer. Now, if you accidentally mute it, obviously you can unmute it, but if your computer crashes, or somehow a cable gets disconnected, or something catastrophic like that, technical, that happens, what do you do? Well, you would have to wait for Waves SuperRack Performer to restart or get your computer connected again and everything like that. And if you're utilizing the routing all the way through from the input into the USB send and then selecting the USB return for your channel processing, you'd have to wait for your computer to get connectivity again before you would actually hear audio again. But if you're utilizing the way that I was showing you in the previous video on utilizing the effect section with the external effect type, you can actually create a snippet to uninsert this like this. And now we have this microphone not passing through Waves. It's just going straight to my left, right, with all my channel processing that I might have. But this would allow you to create a snippet to be able to pull up a uninsert Waves, which would allow you to get back up with audio very quickly, diagnose, figure out what the problem is with Waves or your computer, get it back in on your console, and then you can insert Waves again. So what we can do is we can create a couple snippets inside of our library, use a show, and then use our custom controls to be able to pull those things up. Now, I'm sitting here with the Waves Compact, which is a great console, and on the right-hand side, we have our user section. And to get to this section to be able to program things, we can go to Setup, and then up here, it says CC Edit. And so here, we can go and assign things on our user section. So we can use these buttons as our user-defined section. And then we also have our main left-right fader still here for being able to control audio. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my library and create a show. And so here I'm going to select my internal and I'm going to save this show and we're gonna just title it Waves SuperRack. And so that's just gonna be the name of my show here. So I'm gonna go ahead and save that. Now that we have this show saved, I can go create a couple snippets. I can also add in a snapshot if I wanted to be able to pull up my full version of the board. So let's do that first. So we can go to snapshots and we can go save. And I'm just gonna call this console setup. There we go. So console setup. And so if we go to our show here, we can see that nothing's added in. So what I want to do is I want to go to my console setup, and then I'm just going to press this little button to add it to my show. So I have this show here. I have my console setup saved. Now what I want to do is I want to create two snippets. One snippet for uninserting my effects racks and another for inserting my effects racks. So to do this, what we're going to do is we're going to go over to Snippet and we're going to press record. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go and select our channel, go to our effects rack and turn it off. And go to our next channel and turn it off. And you would repeat this for all of the channels that you have your Waves inserted with this type. So we can see that I now have my two channels here. And if I go back to my library and go to my snippets, we can see that two parameters were recorded. And so what we can do is we can go ahead and press stop, and then we're going to save plus add. So we're going to call this Waves Bypass. So Waves Bypass. And we're going to save. Now what we're going to do is we're going to do another one and record it with them turning on. So to do this, I'm going to go ahead and clear all. I'm going to press record. I'm going to go and select my channel and go turn on my inserts. So we can see that my two channels have my waves inserted. And at this point, you would copy this same type of thing for all the channels that you have with this external effect type inserted. Once you have that done, we'll go back to our library and we'll press stop. And then we can save plus add, and this is going to be called Waves Insert. And we'll press save. Now at this point, what we need to do is we need to assign a tag to these two snippets. So I'm going to go to my Waves Insert, and I'm going to go to my show, and I'm going to press edit tag, and I'm going to go #1 and press OK. And then I'm going to go to my Waves Bypass, and I'm going to edit tag and do #2. Once I have that set, what I need to do is now go and edit my custom controls on my user layer. So to do this, we're going to go setup, and then we're going to go custom control edit. And so I'm going to go and scroll down until we get to scene recall, and I'm going to do scene recall 1. And then I'm going to select the next button, and I'm going to do scene recall 2. And so if we go back to our library, scene recall 1 does my waves insert, scene recall 2 does my waves bypass. And so we can go select one of our channels, go take a look at the effects rack here, and we can see that this is, check, 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 not working because Waves had a crash. For instance, my rack is muted here in Waves SuperRack Performer. And so what I can do is I can go and press scene 2, and that bypassed Waves with the effects. And we have this microphone going to my main left, right. Now, once I go solve my issue inside of Waves, like, oh, I had this muted, I can then go back and push scene 1 for it to insert Waves again on this channel. Now, I can actually go and adjust this even more. So what I can do is I can go back to setup, go to my custom control edit, and this one, I can actually name this. So I can go Waves Insert. And we can see that it now says Waves Insert right here. Another thing I can do is I can go to my color, and I can go color this, press the light, and we can now see that that is green. Now on my scene 2, I'm going to adjust this and give this a Waves Bypass. And I'm going to give this a color of red. And so we can see that I have Waves Insert and Waves Bypass. And so if we go back to my channel, I can go take a look at this, and there's Wave Bypass, and there's Waves Insert. And I can select this at any point in time, and no matter where I have my show control set to, no matter where I have my snippets or my scene recalls or anything like that, if I'm pulling up a different snapshot, as long as I have these same type of effects with the inserts on these channels, when I go press Waves Bypass or Waves Insert, it's going to associate those parameters that we saved in that first snippet. So I will always be able to go and bypass or insert Waves at any moment in time. So for instance, we have this microphone here, check 1, 2, check 1, 2. I'm going to take my USB cable connected to my computer. I'm going to unplug it. And all of a sudden, I have this microphone not working because my computer is completely disconnected. And so we can go and press Waves Bypass. This is working again. And so now I'm going to go and connect this cable back up to my computer here. And we can see that I now have this working again. And so now I can go ahead and press Waves Insert, and we have Waves working again. Now, I hope this video was helpful for you today. If you do happen to have any questions, or there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on the Wing or Waves or really any of the production equipment that's out there, please post that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.